Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 9th October, on the front page you have Rajnath receives first Rafale in France, delivery only next year. So this is first batch of Rafale fighter jets which are being built for the Indian Air Force in France. So the Defence Minister formally received the first Rafale fighter jet, but then they will arrive in India only in May 2020. So, Minister said the jets will boost India's air dominance. So, you should know this was the deal for Rafale fighter jets which we have signed. You can see it was in September 6, 2016, India and France signed 7.87 billion euros intergovernmental agreement for 36 Rafale multi-role fighter jets. So, they will be provided to us in flyaway condition. Means there is no Make in India in this. The earlier program which was there for Make in India, that was cancelled and such. And Prime Minister on his visit to France had this intergovernmental agreement for 36 fighter jets as such, which was made in 2015. Then here you have India-China relations are of global significance. Envoy. So this is regarding upcoming visit of Chinese President Xi Jinping to India, the second informal summit which is going to take place at Mamallapuram. So this is in that context. Then here you have nationwide NRC, center has to set cutoff date. So this is what a senior government official said, that before the center rolls out a plan to compile a countrywide NRC, National Register of Citizens, on the lines of NRC of Assam, it has to decide a cutoff date, a common cutoff date, since when, you know, person will be considered as illegal migrant. Like in the case of Assam, we had the date of 1971 when the war took place between India and Pakistan and Bangladesh was formed as a separate nation. So 25th March 1971 was the cutoff date for NRC of Assam. So similarly, we will have a cutoff date, common cutoff date for the country that will be required, is what this government official says. Then this is Delhi CM's Copenhagen trip stalled. So we had discussed in news how Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal was to attend the C40 cities climate summit in Copenhagen, but then it has to get approval from the central government, the Ministry of External Affairs, and it has not given clearance to Delhi Chief Minister. So he was scheduled to fly on Tuesday. The climate meet is from October 9 to 12. So that has not been approved. Clearance has not been given. And this is lynching alien to India, says Bhagwat. So this is RSS Chief Mohan Bhagwat, who said that lynching was a concept alien to India. So he observed that isolated incidents of social violence should not be labeled with foreign words like lynching to defame the country. Then here you have Canadian American, two Swiss stargazers win Physics Nobel. So Nobel Prize for Physics has been announced. It is James Peebles, who has been awarded for discoveries in cosmology, and Michelle Mayer and Didier Queloz, who have been honored for finding an exoplanet. So here you can see the details of their findings have been given. Peebles, he interpreted the first rays and showed that the universe just 5% is known matter. In universe, as we have seen, known matter and unknown matter, just 5% is known matter, rest is unknown dark matter and dark energy. So we have quite often discussed in cosmology about this known unknown matter. So this was, you know, first interpretation was by Peebles, and he has been awarded Nobel Prize for this. So his insights turned cosmology from speculation to science, sparking further research. And what is dark matter? You should know dark matter is the force which holds together galaxies which otherwise may get torn apart. And so that is dark matter. And dark energy helps the universe's increasingly rapid and constant expansion. So one pulls the other, pushes. So that's the dark energy, as the name has been given. So here you can see it was the Big Bang theory which took place. So universe at that time was in a hot and dense state around 14 billion years ago, and then there was a Big Bang, and then it started expanding and cooling down. So you can see 4 lakh years later, the first rays of light travel through space, and these rays still exist in the cosmos and are omnipresent. This is Peebles' work. And Mayer and Queloz, they discovered earn an exoplanet. It is called 51 Pegasi b. It was first ever find of an exoplanet orbiting a solar type star. So this planet was as big as Jupiter, that is around 1300 times Earth's volume, but it was very close to its star, which was just in orbit. It took 4 days to orbit the star as such. So big planets were thought to be created far from their stars, but then this 51 Pegasi b was so close to its star. So this question led to theories that described how large gas balls formed at the edges of the solar system then spiraled inwards. So they discovered this exoplanet. For that they have been awarded with Nobel Prize. Then on page 9 you have Bhopal gas tragedy survivors left in the lurch as aid funds dry up. So efforts are now on to tap hospital coffers to clear 61.72 crore rupees for additional cases. So the court continues to hear appeals from Bhopal gas tragedy survivors. You can see, so the ex gratia for injuries and disabilities which they have been receiving, that has exhausted, and now the survivors are left in the lurch. Center may soon run out of funds to pay them compensation. So this is the appellate court which is continuing to hear appeals, but there is a hold for now on granting final approval by the Union Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers. This is the status of the compensation being paid even after so many years. It was in 1985 that the Bhopal gas tragedy took place, but still you can see compensation has not been completed. Then below you have rural children breastfeed more survey. So breastfeeding is inversely proportional to household wealth is what comprehensive national nutrition survey found out. So breastfeed up to 1 year and frequent meals as such, you can see, was more in rural children. But then iron deficiency is also less in rural children. Zinc deficiency is more, however. And malnutrition is more from 5 to 9 years of age in rural children. And this is India to work with China, Pakistan to gauge impact of climate change. So a regional center will be set up to better forecast impact on Hindu Kush mountains. So this is what the Indian Meteorological Department is going to do, collaborate with meteorological agencies in China and Pakistan and others too. And Bhopal gas tragedy took place in 1984, so in December, 3rd-4th December 1984. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Advantage BJP. So it says, in Maharashtra, as the opposition is stuck in the past, the ruling party is promising change. So it has better chances is what this editorial says. And second editorial, a delicate balance. So this is regarding Portugal. So again, the politics in Portugal, it says Portugal needs to find a way of boosting growth without affecting welfare measures. So the center-left socialist party in Portugal is seeing a second consecutive term in office now. It has secured 37% of the votes in elections present, which were held in recently. So this is regarding how Portugal needs to boost growth and also ensure welfare measures continue, not with austerity. So that's the idea. And the lead article is stirring up the truth about ZBNF, that is zero budget natural farming. So this article says that this zero budget natural farming has no scientific validation and its inclusion into agricultural policy appears unwise. So this is an article against this concept of zero budget natural farming. So it was popularized by Subhash Palekar and is the most recent entry as such in the policies which government has come up with. So on homeo farming, Vedic farming, nature eco farming, etc., Agnihotra farming, etc. And then here you have rethinking water management issues. So this article says that Niti Aayog strategy for water resources is a continuation of failed policies of the past. So how water management needs to be really put into effect to ensure water for all. So this strategy for New India, which Niti Aayog released, strategy for New India at 75. So it defined clear objectives for 2022-23 with an overview of 41 district areas. But then the strategy for water resources this article says unrealistic. So national water policies as they have come forth, they have been unrealistic, and same continues with Niti Aayog plan 2 is what this article says. It says it fails, water strategy fails on 3 counts. There is no new vision, there is no accountability, and reforms have been overlooked, because when water resources have to be improved, there are real constraints which need to be addressed. Reforms need to be brought in. Like it says, for example, Ken Betwa River Interlinking Project and the India-Nepal Punctuation Project, etc., they need to be completed. But then their major roadblock in their completion is the PILs filed in National Green Tribunal, Supreme Court or High Courts. So how will these be completed? How water resources as they have been planned will be put into effect? These bottlenecks need to be removed. Then on op-ed page, you have this interview with Chinese ambassador to India on the Wuhan summit as such, the boundary question between India and China and the trade deficit. And this is a life in the balance. So this is regarding how India has other options to seek enforcement of International Court of Justice's verdict in the Kulbhushan Jadhav case. So Kulbhushan Jadhav case saw International Court of Justice unanimously holding Pakistan's action as such violative of obligations under the Vienna Convention, and Pakistan was asked to immediately cease its wrongful action. But then India still is having concerns. So how it would put this ICJ ruling into effect is what is being discussed here. There's a recourse to UN Security Council. Then it also talks of an example of how the Nicaragua issue went ahead. So military and paramilitary activities in and against Nicaragua was a concern at that time. So judgment was in favor of Nicaragua, but then it had to call upon US to comply with the judgment, and as such it approached the UN Security Council when US did not comply. And this is regarding India-Mexico. It says the exchanges between India and Mexico this week represent an opportunity to strengthen bilateral ties. So a strategic partnership between India and Mexico, which have completed 69 years of diplomatic relations. It was a privileged partnership which was established in 2007. So it has to be enhanced to strategic partnership now. Then on page 12, you have what we saw on the front page regarding nationwide NRC, how a common cutoff date will be required. Because several states are demanding a register, though they are competent enough to detect and report foreign nationals. Regarding the issue, you can see Tripura case specifically mentioned. A civil society group, the Tripura People's Front, filed a petition in Supreme Court in October 2018 seeking an NRC exercise in the state by taking 19 July 1948 as the cutoff date. So such demands have come from many states. So a cutoff date would be required is the point here. Then on international page, you have loyalists slam Trump over Syria troops pullout move. So allies in the grand old party, that is the Republican Party, say the decision which President Donald Trump took to pull out troops from Syria would help Russia and Iran in the region and also lead to revival of Islamic State. And here you have US blacklist top Chinese firms over rights violation. So US government has widened its trade blacklist to include some of Chinese top artificial intelligence startups, punishing Beijing for its treatment of Muslim minorities and ratcheting up tensions ahead of high-level trade talks which are going to take place between US and China. So officials say the action is not tied to the upcoming trade talks, but then this is a fact that China's top artificial intelligence startups have been blacklisted. Then below you have Trio win medicine Nobel Prize. So two Americans and a British scientist won Nobel Prize for medicine for discovering details of how body cells sense and react to low oxygen levels. So this has provided a foothold for developing new treatments for anemia, cancer and other diseases. So the scientists have been awarded for their work here. also page before, on page 13, you have two important news. One is China changes tack on Kashmir. So China has now dropped reference to UN role in Kashmir, and it calls for direct dialogue between India and Pakistan. So ahead of Chinese President Xi Jinping's visit to India, this is what China has done. It has dropped references to role of UN in resolving Kashmir issue. And this is Kashmir curbs devastating, says US House Committee. So this is US House Foreign Affairs Committee. It has said that communications shutdown is having devastating impact on Kashmiris and has called for the restrictions to be lifted. It says India, it is time for India to lift these restrictions. Then on business page you have FPI flows stay muted post tax rate cuts. So this is regarding foreign portfolio investments. So the foreign portfolio investments still remain low as such even after tax rate cuts. So International Monetary Fund and Asian Development Bank are cutting growth forecast, and there is a trade war going on. Trump's impeachment inquiry is going on, which is having its consequence on global investors. And you can see FPI flows in the country remained muted. And below you have government unveils faceless IT assessment, opens national e-assessment center. So Revenue Secretary has launched the faceless assessment system in the Income Tax Department and also inaugurated national e-assessment center, which promise that finance minister had made in her budget speech. So this e-assessment scheme as such is team-based assessment, concept of team-based assessment with dynamic jurisdiction, which would bring about transparency, efficiency and standardization of procedures by eliminating human interface between taxpayer and the income tax departments. So that's the idea. So this e-assessment center as such has been launched. Also recently, Central Board of Direct Taxes launched a system wherein all notices and communications sent by IT department would come with a computer generated documentation identification number, DIN. So notices without DIN will be considered non-existent. So this is also there. So that is it. So these were the important headlines. Post this, then you have sports related news, even on the last page. So that is it. Thank you.